In this video, we are going to create such an object here, the so-called Gann Fan. And we want to find out how to do that with MQL5. To get started, please click on a little icon here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the MetaEditor window, and here you want to click on File, New File, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file SimpleHighGannFan, click on Continue, Continue and Finish. Now you can delete everything above the OnTick function. And let's remove the two command lines here. We are going to calculate the number of candles on the chart, and that can be done by using ChartGetInteger. The first parameter is for the chart ID 0. The second one is called ChartFirstVisibleBar. And if you mark that and press F1, you will see that it returns the number of the first visible bar on the chart. The last parameter is for the sub window. The one with the candles is window 0. Now let's create a variable for the highest candle. And I would also like to create an array for the highest prices. It is called high. And it will contain all the highest prices for each candle on the chart. First, we need to use array set as series to sort the high array from the current candle downwards. And now we can use a function called copy high. This one will give us the highest bar prices for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on that chart. We want to start with the current candle 0 for all the candles on the chart and copy the values into our high array. And now we can get the highest candle by using this function, array maximum. That will give us the largest element in our array. The array is called high. We want to start to search for the highest candle with candle 0. And go through all the candles on the chart, and the result is the number of the highest candle. We also need to use MQL rates for another array called price information, because MQL rates also stores the time. And for each object, we need to know the time and the value to draw it. Let's also sort this one with array set as series from the current candle downwards. And now we can fill the array with data by using copy rates for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on that chart. Starting from the current candle 0 for all the candles on the chart, we want to store the price information in our array. Before we can create a new object, we want to use object delete for the current symbol on the chart and the object that is called SimpleHighGannFan. We use object delete to remove old objects before we draw a new one. This will not be the case the very first time we call this function, but afterwards we always have an old object that needs to be removed. And to draw an object, we use object create. The first parameter 0 is for the chart ID. The second parameter is the object name. In my case, it's SimpleHighGannFan. Basically, you can use any name you want, but you need to use the exact same name everywhere. Parameter 3 is the object type. We have used obg underscore GannFan, and if you mark that and press F1, you will see that there are different object types. We use this one. It will draw these lines on our candle chart. We want to draw it inside of the main chart with the candles, so that's the window 0. My starting point is the time when the highest candle inside of our price information array was drawn. And I would like to have it for the highest price of the highest candle. The second point in time will be the current time when the current candle 0 is drawn. And the value will be the highest price of the current candle. And that's it for the object create part. Of course, you can use other values here, but for this simple example, it's good enough. Now let's change a few properties. That can be done by using object set integer. For chart ID 0, I would like to change a property for the object that is called SimpleHighGannFan. The property I want to change is object property color, and I would like to change it to orange. Another property is called object property direction. The first part is the same, but this time we want to change this property, and I have used Gann downtrend here. That stands for a line corresponding to the downward trend. Let's modify another property. This one is called object property scale, and I have used a value of 2. And finally, the last one, this is called object property ray right. I have set it to true, and it will be used to draw the line to the current candle and into the future. So far, so good. If this was too fast for you, or if you have no idea what all the code here does, maybe you want to watch one of the other videos in this basic video series, or maybe even the premium course on our website might be interesting for you. For now, I want to click on View, Toolbar, and click on the Compile button, or press F7. This should work without any errors, and if that is the case, you can click on a little button here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. And in MetaTrader, we want to click on View, Strategy Tester. Please pick the new file SimpleHighGannFan.exe5, mark the option for the visual mode here, and start a test. Here we are. Our object is drawn on the chart. We can zoom in or out, and the lines will be adjusted. So our little expert advisor works as designed. And in this little video, you have learned how to create a Gann Fan object right on your chart, and you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL5 code.